Are you stuck with dumbbells and want to train your back? Well, stick around for this dumbbell-only back workout. Okay, so we're stuck with dumbbells and we want to completely train our back. So how are we going to do this? So when it comes to how many exercises you need per muscle group, I would say between 1 to 3. Literally, each muscle group does about 1 to 3 things tops. And when it comes to back, I think we can literally hit the entire back by doing 2 exercises. Now, we only have dumbbells. How are we going to do that? First of all, let's do some pullovers. Pullovers can help us attack just our lats by doing basically shoulder extension. We're in the position here and pulling straight over across. And then to hit the rest of our back when it comes to our lats, rhomboids, traps, rear delts, and erectors, we're gonna do a bent over dumbbell row. Now, you can do a chest support. The difference is you're gonna have a little more stability when it comes to a chest support and your erectors aren't gonna be engaged as much. So that's what we're doing, bent over dumbbell row, so we can get everything working at once. So let's start. I'm gonna start off with dumbbell pullovers. Now, there's a couple ways we could set up. You could set up a few ways. You can set up perpendicular to the bench being this way, or we can line up in the entire bench by just laying this way. What I prefer, I like more, is actually lying perpendicular on the bench. I feel it gives me a little more stability, and I can kind of balance myself a little bit with my hips. Now, I'll show you how to set up first. But before we start, our sets and reps are gonna be long and slow. We wanna really elongate these sets by using a weight that allows us to do that and keeps us at a risk from getting injured. If you're gonna sit on the bench perpendicular, what I wanna do first is get this dumbbell here. Then I'm gonna line up almost like I'm doing a hip thrust. Good. So I wanna make sure that my back is on the bench. Basically my traps and my neck are stable from here. And this is how I wanna be set up. So when I am back like this, my head's not sitting back like this and I'm choke myself out and my neck's doing a bunch of work. Got a little bit of stability here and your arms and basically your shoulders are gonna be retracted and we pull back. We have great stability from here. Now, from the floor, I wanna make sure that my knees, I wanna make sure my feet are a little bit underneath my knees. And you also wanna feel like you're doing a hip thrust. So at the top of the hip thrust, we're gonna be here, right straight across. This is gonna give us a lot more stability and it's gonna help counterbalance the weight. So when we're back this way, it's gonna feel like we're in balance. So from here, I'm gonna reach over. First, I'm gonna put this hand underneath and then I'm gonna get the other hand and I'm gonna roll over to my side from here. Hands underneath from this way. And then I'm gonna use my weight to counterbalance myself and pull this up to the beginning spot. Now from here, adjusting myself again. And now, we're gonna start the descent. We're gonna go back for a 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, a nice stretch. And then pulling up and keeping your chest high. Hey, yo. Going down again, 1,001, 1,002, 1,003. Now at this point here, I wanna make sure my hands are flat. And right now, all the tension is on my lats. And then pulling up. And a couple of things we wanna make sure is the elbows are pointing out. So when we go back, our arms don't bend. If they're pointing in, we get this, and then all of a sudden we're doing a little bit of a tricep exercise and you're wondering why your triceps are hurting or gassed out before you even feel your lats. So from here, internally rotate at the shoulders so your elbows are pointing out. Push your arms back, reach back far, keep the chest up nice and tall, the hips up tall. And then you can have a nice stretch from here, pulling from your palms. Keep the chest up and right back to starting position. Right here, so there's still tension. We don't wanna go this far here because now there's really not much tension at all. So we wanna finish, just say like over your nose and back again. And we're done. We're gonna go back to the side we started, putting it down from here and then wrap. So we're gonna do just straight sets. 10 to 15 reps, 3 second negative. 1 second pause in the lengthening contraction or the stretch, and then a controlled concentric or positive to the shortened or to the squeeze. We're gonna do 3 sets, 10 to 15 reps, like Temba just said, and then make sure that we're resting around 2 minutes. 3 minutes you have to push if you're a little tired, but we also wanna make sure that we're taking these sets too close to failure. I don't wanna go to failure here because it's a very vulnerable position to be in, so take it to about like 2 to 3,
reps in reserve, or even like just an 8 RPE.
Okay, so next exercise, guys, we're doing bent over dumbbell rows. Now, nothing crazy at all, just straight sets. Again, we wanna have good controlled movements. Now, when I'm doing any type of hinging exercise or I'm not chest support, I'm not really necessarily looking for a long negative on the way down. Why? Well, because your back's gonna gas out before your lats will in this position, which is completely fine, but we wanna make sure that we're hitting the lats before our back is tired. So what I want from here is, again, so setting yourself up just like you're doing a Romanian deadlift. For this, feet are gonna be about shoulder width apart, hip width from here. And then again, dumbbells in my hands from here, shoulders back and away from my ears. And then I wanna push my hips back and then soft my knees a bit. I don't want them going forward. I wanna sit them back more and more. So I'm sitting like this, I'm sitting into my glutes, shins are straight, my core is engaged. And from here, I'm gonna let my arms naturally relax from here. And then our roll is gonna be from here, protracted, pull in a retraction, and then all the way up, and then down. And you'll be, the rep will be here, stretch. So we don't need 1, 2, 3, we don't need that. What we need is from here, you could squeeze, open up, squeeze, open up. And remember, make sure that we have perfect contact from heel to toe throughout the entire foot. So you're gonna feel your calves, your hamstrings, your glutes, and your erectors keeping you stable, giving you leverage, and make sure we engage your core when we start. And again, guys, we're gonna take this to close to failure, 10 to 15 reps, controlled. And make sure we adjust our load so we push that 2 to 3 RIR or 8 RPE. What do I mean by that? It means if we're doing 10 to 15 reps and you get to 15, you can do 5 more reps, it's not heavy enough. I want you to struggle at least to 10 and then work your way up to 15 to start and progressive overload from there, or have a weight that gets you into that 10 to 15 rep range. The second you do more than 15, add more weight. If you can't do at least 10 with the same consistent tempo and form and range of motion, then it's too heavy. Lighten your load accordingly so you can do the exercise efficiently. Okay, so last but not least, we're gonna do dumbbell curls. This time we're doing on the incline bench. Now, when we're setting this up, we wanna make sure we avoid the excessive incline. I'll show you what that looks like. Don't set it back to this because it's too far back. So as soon as you get the dumbbells, what's gonna happen? It's gonna stretch his arm way too far back from here. And you can see right now, my delt's taking a lot of the stretch right now, and I'm not trying to stretch my delt. So what we wanna do is put it like this. Then when I'm sitting down from here, my shoulder's in a better position, and all I'm doing is curling right to here, and then controlling it down. A couple of big things to make it easier for you. Keep your legs close. Oftentimes I see legs like this, and then as soon as you start to curl, you got, bam, right in the back of the leg. Narrow your stance up a little bit. It keeps the dumbbells clear and free so you can actually curl without any disruption from the rest of your body. Now again, with this, what I want, we're gonna make this one just as hard as the other ones by just controlling it. Nothing fancy, nothing crazy, just sitting back, chest up, curling up, and then we're gonna take it down a little slow. 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, stretch up. 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, stretch up. That's a 6-second rep. How many reps are we gonna do? You're gonna do 5 to 15 reps. Why do I say 5 to 15 reps? Well, because it's a 6-second rep. 6 times 5 is 30. Are you gonna be able to do 15? Maybe, maybe not. But we're just gonna give you a minimum amount of rep range, and then depending on the load you're using, you might be able to get 15, you might be able to only get 5. But what we wanna do is make sure that you're getting in between that range so we're getting the maximum amount of muscle hypertrophy by creating a lot of tension by making the set a lot longer with a load that can allow you to do so without putting your body at risk of injury. I picked up 35s on accident, that means I gotta do them. I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like from the 5 to 15 reps of a 6-second rep.
That is my first set of using 35-pound dumbbells with strict tempo, strict form, and great range of motion, consistent. And how do you know you're coming to failure or you can't squeeze another rep? Well, if you watch me the entire lift, there was no momentum. I wasn't trying to swing my way up. I wasn't using my feet. I was just going straight from back and up. And the second that I cannot go from here, that's failure. We don't have to push any further than that. That set there is what it looks like to actually create muscle tension in the most optimal way. So as long as your set kind of looks like that, you're in the clear. You guys are gonna do four sets of incline dumbbell curls, 5 to 15 reps, 6 second rep. 4 seconds down, 1 second to pause, 1 second concentric or positive. Anyway guys, that's it for today's video guys. If you guys liked it, make sure you guys like, subscribe, and share. You know I'm gonna come with the telekinetic, transparent, vulnerable truth. And for coaching guys, JonniShreve.com. If you wanna know more about my coaching guys, book yourself a 1 hour video consult with myself. We talk about training, nutrition, supplementation, or mental health. Just you and me, we chop it up. And at the end of that consult guys, I'd deduct $100 off any package that you pick. Anyway guys, until next time, you know how it is. Iron Chef is iron, progressive overload your life. In the meantime, keep dream chasing. Peace.